"You didn't know that Mr. Yoop was married, or that after he was cruelly captured his wife still lived in his castle and ran it to suit herself."
"Who captured Mr. Yoop?" asked Woot, looking gravely at the big woman.
"Wicked enemies, people who selfishly objected to Yoop's taking their cows and sheep for his food. I must admit, however, that Yoop had a bad temper, and had the habit of knocking over a few houses now and then when he was angry. So one day the little folks came in a great crowd and captured Mr. Yoop, and carried him away to a cage somewhere in the mountains. I don't know where it is, and I don't care. For my husband treated me badly at times, forgetting the respect a giant owes to a giantess. Often he kicked me on my shins when I wouldn't wait on him. So I'm glad he is gone."
"It's a wonder the people didn't capture you, too," remarked Woot.
"Well, I was too clever for them," said she, giving a sudden laugh that caused such a breeze that the wobbly scarecrow was almost blown off his feet and had to grab his friend Nick Chopper to steady himself. "I saw the people coming," continued Mrs. Yoop, "and knowing they meant mischief, I transformed myself into a mouse and hid in a cupboard. After they had gone away, carrying my shin-kicking husband with them, I transformed myself back to my former shape again, and here I've lived in peace and comfort ever since."
"Are you a witch, then?" inquired Woot.
"Well, not exactly a witch," she replied, "but I'm an artist in transformations. In other words, I'm more of a yookoohoo than a witch. And of course you know that the yookoohoos are the cleverest magic workers in the world."
The travelers were silent for a time, uneasily considering this statement and the effect it might have on their future. No doubt the giantess had willfully made them her prisoners. Yet she spoke so cheerfully in her big voice that until now they had not been alarmed in the least. By and by the scarecrow, whose mixed brains had been working steadily, asked the woman, "Are we to consider you our friend, Mrs. Yoop, or do you intend to be our enemy?"
"I never have friends," she said in a matter-of-fact tone, "because friends get too familiar and always forget to mind their own business. But I'm not your enemy, not yet, anyhow. Indeed, I'm glad you've come, for my life here is rather lonely. I've had no one to talk to since I transformed Polychrome, the daughter of the rainbow, into a canary bird."
"How did you manage to do that?" asked the Tin Woodman in amazement. "Polychrome is a powerful fairy."
"She was," said the giantess, "but now she's a canary bird. One day after a rain, Polychrome danced off the rainbow and fell asleep on a little mound in this valley not far from my castle.